Hi guys, it is time to marinate the turkey, and I have described this before, but I'm gonna do it with you guys so that you can see. It's Tuesday afternoon, so this is going to be marinating for about 36 hours. I'm crushing a tablespoon of peppercorns, and usually I would soak this in this beautiful tierra negra pot. Can you see it? But it occurred to me this year we're having such a small Thanksgiving that I can actually fit it in my Dutch oven. So I have a tablespoon of peppercorns that I have crushed, dry roasted and crushed, and I'm putting that on the bottom. And then I'm going to put a few, just not too many, just a few, because it can get really perfumey. Sage leaves, that's already too many. Let's do, there. We hope that's not too many. And then I'm gonna do just a little bit of rosemary. The orange, the garlic, the peppercorns, and the rosemary will go into the cavity after it's been rubbed with sea salt, and then around the bird we'll put the apples and onions and more herbs like bay leaves. And we're gonna put a couple bay leaves in here so that all that fruit will break down and it'll make more beautiful pan juices for the gravy. So we're going to marinate our turkey in buttermilk, which is very thick. And the reason I'm doing this first is because I want to be able to season it with salt and sugar as well. This is a 12-pound turkey, and I'm hoping, because we are so small a group, just me and my cousin, sister, Regini, and her kids, that we'll have enough for turkey pot pie with the leftover gravy, which is actually, for me, the highlight of Thanksgiving, even more than the turkey. Okay, so I'm going to add a heaping teaspoon of sugar in the raw. I might add more, but not yet. I want to taste it. So it's similar. I don't have any measurements. I kind of just do it by taste. And it's similar to pickling liquid, but less intense, I think. And I'm not really brining the turkey. I'm just marinating it in this buttermilk. You can use milk too. There's more enzymes in buttermilk, especially if you buy the unhomogenized kind, which I got some of at the farmer's market. And that will break down the proteins in the meat, especially the duck. So now we're gonna immerse this bird. Boy. You wanna put the feet down or the legs down first. Perfect. Now, I would really like it to have it all over, but this is the biggest pot that is still small enough to fit in my fridge. Usually I do it outside on the terrace, but we're actually gonna have a warm day tomorrow and I'm worried that it won't be cold enough. Okay. And that's it. We've marinated the turkey in buttermilk, spices and seasonings, and then we'll bake it early morning. Bye.